Of lace ruffles, perukes and brocade. Brown Bess was a partner whom none could despise. An outspoken, flinty-lipped, brazen-faced jade, with a habit of looking men straight in the eyes. And Blenheim and Ramillies, Fops would confess, they were pierced to the heart by the charms of Brown Bess. Though her sight was not long, that her weight was not small, yet her actions were winning, her language was clear, and everyone bowed as she opened the ball on the arm of some high-gated grim grenadier. Europe admitted the striking success of the dances and routes that were given by Brown Bess. When ruffles were turned into stiff leather stocks, and people wore pigtails instead of perukes, Brown Bess never altered her iron grey locks. She knew she was valued for more than her looks. So powder and patches was always my dress, and I think I am killing an upset Brown Bess. So she followed her redcoats, whatever they did, from the heights of Quebec to the plains of Assay, from Gibraltar to Acre, Cape Town and Madrid. And nothing about her was changed on the way. Most of the empire which we now possess was won through those years by old-fashioned Brown Bess. In stubborn retreat or in stately advance, Portugal coast to the Cork woods of Spain, she had puzzled some excellent marshals of France, till none of them wanted to meet her again. But later near Brussels, Napoleon no less arranged for a war to dance till the dawn of that terrible day. She had danced till the dusk of more terrible night. For her link squares, his battalions gave way, and her long fist quadrilles put his lances to flight. When his skilled carriage drove off in the press, I have danced my last dance for the world, said Brown Bess. Go to museums, there's one in Whitehall, where her old weapons are shown with the names writ beneath. You'll find her upstanding, her back to the wall, as stiff as a ramrod, the flint in her teeth. And if ever we English had reason to bless any arm save our mothers, that arm is